Jason Silva's Nicole, how's his word description?
To the world, I was the star of Brain Games, a television program that inspired millions of people around the world.
Where did your sense of curiosity, could you know where it came from?
I was able to achieve fame at a young age. I had money and influence. I started to feel the burden and the pressure to stay relentless and continue to succeed. I started suffering from panic attacks and anxiety attacks, and I understood that to regain my connection to inner peace, I was going to have to face my fears. I was going to have to understand what makes me happy. Moved by this, I decided to go on a personal search of sorts to the island of Aruba, which is known as the Happy Island. So this is a kind of spiritual quest for me to understand what it is that makes Aruba such a happy place. And I was going to explore through the four elements, through water, through earth, through air, and through fire. Element is present in every corner of Aruba's geography, which is shaped by the force of the winds and the waves that sculpt its mountains and coasts, and even gives shape to its trees. The air makes me think about breathing to control my anxiety. It is the organizing force. It symbolizes the spiritual world, freedom, art, culture. And that is why I now want to understand the importance of air in the creation of Aruba's identity and the role it plays in building the happiness of the island. I'm going to begin my exploration of the air element with Ethan. Ethan is a windsurfer that competes internationally. And he leads an organization in Aruba to bring the sport of windsurfing to young people. Ethan.
How are you doing, Jason?
Hey, good to see you. Good to meet you.
How Welcome are you? On Aruba. Welcome
Thank
on Aruba.
You. Nice to meet
nice
you.
Nice to meet
man.
You too.
Tell me a little bit about growing up here. You from Aruba?
Yeah, I was born and raised here.
It looks like a happy place to grow up.
Definitely a happy place to grow up. For me, it was always like a sense of freedom. And I didn't know better than how it was on Aruba. Mm-hmm. When I started traveling, I realized, wow, we really are lucky to be on Aruba, you know, and be free and not worry about so many things. I guess it's just a sense of freedom you have and being alone and doing something that no one tells you what to do or, you know, and
total freedom.
Total freedom. And I can do it every day, the whole day on Aruba. So I guess that's just stuck with me.
Unbelievable. Is a relationship between you, your craft, and the air. So do you see the wind and the air as part of your relationship with freedom and with happiness?
Definitely, definitely. Because when there's no wind, I can't do my sport, you know? And
right.
My sport, windsurfing, is
right.
That's my medicine, you know? Because if I don't do it for 1 week, you already start feeling, oh, I'm getting a bit hyper, I need to do something, and I need to let it go. And of course, it's also It's the wind, but it's also the water, of course, because
yeah.
The water is a big part for me, and especially when there gets wavy or wavy conditions,
for
you
sure.
Fall in love even more, you know. Of course, there's highs and lows in doing it, but I'm just grateful that I can do it, and
yeah.
I don't know better. Also, this is my life, you know.
I dig it, man. Paint for me your relationship with happiness.
Well, I'm a different kind of person because I've been competing now for many years. So
okay.
For me, it's just the process to it of working really hard. And when you work, having the road of 1-2 years and then you accomplishing your goal, that's happiness for me, you know, that I really accomplished something and I believed in it. And so many years, I just stick to it and I make it. Because windsurfing, I really love it. I do it because I love it. So that's really, now for me in my career, that's happiness, you know.
So it's goal oriented.
Yeah,
you
sure.
wanna achieve certain key things.
For sure, I want to
victory.
Be able to sail with the best in the world, you know, and be able to win also.
So you also have a windsurfing club. You take children, kids out, and teach them. Tell me how that worked.
Yeah, so on Aruba, windsurfing is not an easy sport to get in contact with because you need quite some money to start up. Okay. So our club that we have, the WRCA, they provide like equipment and kids or coaches that can help them to get started up in windsurfing. And they have programs for every month or every 3 months that you can do that every weekend. Mm-hmm. And then they can get better at that, progress, and then they can slowly fall in love with windsurfing on Aruba.
And where did this passion for helping children and teaching children come from?
Well, on Aruba, we always have a really good view of where we're standing in our sport, and we know that it's just expensive sport.
Yeah.
So everyone always has an open mind in that and always want to have more people and more kids joining the sport because we have amazing athletes that came from Aruba that is windsurfing. If kids can see that and they can envision that, and yeah, they can just love the sport. That's the most important, you know.
You've had the opportunity to travel the world, you've competed, you've seen places and spaces, and you come back to this happy island where you were born.
Yeah.
What has seeing the world taught you about Aruba?
Has taught me a lot, you know. Every time I leave, like, I get sad, actually, because I'm leaving such a beautiful place. But traveling has also given me a lot. But at the same time, every time I leave, like, I see how, for me, it's like the real world is like how it is outside, Europe, the States. And when I come back, it's just like paradise. So for me to call this home is just, you know, everything's being so mellow, everything being not so, yeah, just a bit easier, calmer, and being with happy people that just want to see you every day and be in contact with you, and just watching the sunsets, you know, simple stuff that really...
The little things are the big things,
yeah,
man. Okay, Ethan, so can you give me a sense of how this all works? Bit of a lesson here?
Of course. Welcome to our home spot in Aruba, the windsurfing place.
Thank you.
This is our beginner set. So people that just start windsurfing, they will get a set like this. So it's easier for them to get into it. The most important that we need to know is the wind comes from our back.
Okay.
It's offshore, always on Aruba, mostly of the year.
Okay.
So the sail will always be on the outside and not in the inside, all right?
It was amazing to connect with Ethan. I mean, his love for windsurfing is so obvious, and the guy has entered into a wonderful coupling, a wonderful relationship with the wind, with the air, and the fact that it allows him to propel forward, to engage in a physical sport that is completely technology independent. It's just him and nature using this tool and leveraging the wind is just an incredible thing. Of course, there's a learning curve here. As you saw, he gave me a lesson, and it's gonna take a little while, I think, before I can get into the same zone as Ethan. But as far as happiness is concerned, using this sport of windsurfing, he's got a rich environment, he's got deep embodiment, and he's got high consequence, which is the recipe for happiness, the recipe for a flow state. And incredible guy. I'm so happy I got to meet him. It is said that air is the element of creativity, the element of culture. And in continuing to explore the role of air in art and creativity and happiness, I'm now going to meet Watra. She's an incredible singer and writer that uses music and poetry inspired by the natural environment, as well as her connection to Aruba's history and origins, indigenous culture, and more to express herself. Let's meet her. Watra, I want to hear your story and how that story connects to this island and how your music was born. Tell me everything.
I was born in Holland, in Amsterdam, and then when it was 2000, that's when we came to move here. My family's very musical. My grandfather, my grandmother, they all sing or play an instrument. I think that's a big part of how I got inspired. Until, you know, when I was older, when I was 20, that's when I realized how much Aruba plays a big part in my writing, in the music that I compose, because there has always been this calmness about Aruba. And that played a big role in the music that I compose today, is I really care about leaving space into my music, you know, letting for you to hear breeze or the ocean sounds. Like, those are little nature elements that I love to incorporate.
is Aruba a kind of muse in a way?
I think muse, it's especially more of a safe haven, especially the space that was created for me to just be. But I would say it's more the people and the experiences that has inspired my music or just inspired the woman that I am.
And you feel seen by Aruba in turn?
I feel seen by Aruba in many ways.
Yeah.
To be more specific, I've studied here and I've also worked here and I have a social work background and also social pedagogical work. So in that way, I see very, very seen. Music-wise, the first time where I felt seen in a broader aspect, because if you're talking about more of a minor, it's, I would say, my first talent show at my high school in Aruba, for sure. I was like, I felt awesome. It was like a biggest challenge. But to really recognize, like, okay, this is my connection with Aruba, this is something that I can actually contribute, is actually the place where we're at right now.
Tell me more.
Yes.
So, where are we?
Yeah, we're at Fort Southman. It's in a historical place on Aruba. Right now, it's also being displayed as a museum. All right, Jason, so this is inside the historical museum.
Okay, beautiful.
Fort Southman. So this is where I would like get the jitters and
sure.
get a little bit nervous, do some breathing or a warm up before going outside. And now that we're here, and thank you for agreeing with doing this musical experience.
Oh yeah, I'm in on that.
There's one word that I would like for us to create on.
Okay.
And that word is quita.
Quita.
Quita means remove. Whatever you feel, like what are the first two things that you feel you want to just remove, leave behind with this journey, that you feel it doesn't belong to you or it's not serving you, you know?
Fear.
Fear.
Fear, anxiety.
Yeah.
Unnecessary.
Yes.
Anxiety. Quita.
We're about to snap a rhythm.
All right.
And try to maintain that rhythm. Right. You got it. Okay. And then I'm going to sing a sentence in Papiamento. And every time I finish with that sentence, you say, quita.
All right.
Quita miedo. Quita. Quita miedo y dolor. Quita.
Quita.
Yes. Quita tu locura. No te valora. Quita el miedo. Ning mi corazón.
Quita.
Thank you so much.
Thank
you. Listen to the Well, the area that we are at right now is called Mangal Alto.
Okay.
And it is a very special place for me.
The story untold.
And I used to come here with a lot of family members for family parties, activities, but also sometimes just to relax and to take in the air, you know, or get creative.
Find some solitude.
Exactly. I'm gonna take my slippers off because I love feeling the sand and having my feet on the ground. And this song, Waves, represents many things. Reminds me of every time I came here and to be alone or to get some clarity. The nature has its answers for us already.
I believe that one day I will not see clearly to face what is haunting me away.
I consider the ocean and the waves, the sounds of the waves being one of them. So that's kind of what this song represents.
Come and I pray and realize that the sound of the waves, they say what I need to say. And the sound of the waves.
Thank you.
guitar riff as well.
Yeah. Thank you. I hear a whole percussion set and everything with it. But this is definitely a part that I wanted to share.
Thank you.
As I continue on this adventure, it becomes increasingly clear that creativity plays a huge role in people's happiness and life satisfaction. I mean, any artist will tell you that they're only really happy when they are creating. And no doubt, artists contribute to the collective happiness of a society as well. Well, in this island, everybody talks about Armando as one of the most prolific creatives around. He creates some of the most famous murals in Aruba, where he represents the nature of the island in all of its rapture.
Armando.
Hi, you must be Jason.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, man.
How's it going?
Good, good.
Sorry to interrupt, but it looks like you're doing something masterful here.
Thanks, thanks. Yeah, I'm working on the Burring Owl family here.
Okay.
And yeah, I love to paint nature. I go out, take reference images, and make nice compositions and paint them on canvas.
How wonderful.
Yes.
Reverential act and celebration of nature.
Absolutely, yeah.
Take me on a journey.
I will show you around. Let's go.
Okay, sounds great. Let's do this. Wow.
Followed a lot of workshops here.
Simple things, that is life. Playing rhythms to make it.
Look at that. Okay, my friend. So let me ask you about the creative process. Have you dealt with self-doubt, insecurity, fear before you begin something new?
Yeah, absolutely. Every time I see a piece like this, it becomes very challenging for me because it's like, whew, you don't want to mess it up. But at the same time, I always see it as a moment where I can release some of the tension that I have either inside of things that are happening around. There are just so many possibilities, and it's often to me more like an endless stuff.
Yeah.
Which is what you can find on this island.
Yeah.
There's like so many beautiful things.
For sure. So what would you say is the relationship or the coupling between your work and your sense of fulfillment and happiness?
Because if I'm not making my art, I do notice there's like this, I can sometimes go into depression.
Yeah.
And even though I can see like an assignment coming, I still get a lot of anxiety and worry. Like, will I be able to do this? Will I like doing this?
Yeah.
Even those thoughts come in.
Yeah.
But when I work on the assignment, it's just so much stuff going loose and and beauty, like happiness. So Jason, this is my first mural.
Okay.
I made this one 5 years ago.
All right. Looks a little bit bleached now.
Yeah, I think I should restore it soon because it would be great if it gets the vibrant colors back.
I take it we're approaching your masterpiece.
Yes.
Hummingbirds.
Mm-hmm.
The parrotfish,
right? The queen parrotfish, yeah.
I really appreciate how much you love the island and the nature, and you're sort of an ambassador for the natural wonders, which is a beautiful thing.
Yeah.
What's it like when you're making something like this? Tell me about the state of consciousness you get into. Do you vanish in the experience? Is it bliss, joy, happiness the whole time?
It's especially like creating like a visual piece that showcases things in a different way from the usual.
Mm-hmm. I think these kinds of murals are extraordinary, man. I think they're contemporary cave paintings. I went with an archaeologist and he took me into the caves and we were just kind of basking in the artful expressiveness of ancient man, you know, like the first instance of exteriorizing the imagination. And that was then and this is now, you know, this will last.
Yeah, we'll see how long it will last. Hopefully very long.
Long time.
Yeah.
It's a nice little paradise you got here though, man.
Yeah, definitely.
Every day is a chance for deep introspection.
Yes, the colors, the shapes. It's really raw out here, so.
Yeah.
So I just often love to photograph the birds.
Sure.
And then go home and analyze the feathers and the colors.
Mm-hmm.
Make a nice composition and then I paint them. And also the sounds, if you can hear a lot of bird sounds. It's because of the migratory season just started.
Okay.
we get about 250 bird species coming over. So you can imagine how many birds you can spot in the wild. Some are very small, some are big. Colors vary, of course. This is the orange oriole. In Aruba, we call it the trupial.
Okay.
Yes.
Trupial, I think we call that in Venezuela, too.
Yeah. We do have two species here, from the, what I know. We have the yellow one and the orange one.
All right.
Yes. To me, it's not important to become like the best artist of the world. That's not my goal. I just want to become the best artist in myself.
Wow, this is a good spot.
Yeah.
Majestic views.
A lot of colors in there.
Gorgeous.
Yeah. It's a beautiful cactus here.
Oh, man. It's your temple here.
Yes, absolutely. It's one of my favorite roads to take when I go surfing.
Yeah, yeah.
One of my favorite surf spots, so. This island has so many colors and shapes. It's endless. It's very small, but each place you go to, I mean, as you can see, we have
feels vast.
Yeah, absolutely.
That was a wonderful experience to connect with Armando. He's a beautiful artist, connected really to his passion from capturing birds in flight. He overcame a lot of self-doubt. He overcame a lot of fear. He overcame a lot of anxiety. But as many artists find, once you learn to lose yourself in your work, you find freedom from that chatter and find a place of wholeness and love that comes from losing yourself again in your art. Wonderful guy, incredible guy, and real representative of that relationship of lightness and creativity and the airiness that's found when you're inspired. Well, for us, the element of air has been about exploring creativity. How do we leverage the air to transcend our limitations? Of course, Watra has to engage her vocal cords and has to breathe in order to sing and to communicate. We talk about leveraging the air in order to windsurf and soar beyond our limitations. My own creative blockages and my fear of public speaking was something that I had to overcome by learning how to breathe. We don't just need air to breathe to stay alive, but we've got to learn to breathe to downregulate our nervous system, overcome our anxiety, transcend our creative blockages. And so we need to have a relationship with breath, a relationship with air that goes far beyond mere survival. Water, earth, air. We've looked at all of these elements, and in the next part of our journey, we're gonna look at fire. Fire as an alchemizing force. Fire as a force of destruction, necessary destruction, so that we can have renewal. Fire destroys and creates.
In my case, it creates something beautiful.
Humanity has had an incredible relationship with fire. We use fire to cook our foods. We sit around the campfire and tell stories.
Why not using these materials to
for
something else to create?
Fire opens up the imagination, but fire is also something to be feared.
It's the element of transformation. It's the element of movement.
But when properly harnessed, fire can power the engines in our airplanes. And so it should be an interesting deep dive into this incredible element.